Can I just second that?
You could totally second that.
Yeah.
Love is in the
Let
air. It's going to be even better.
Yeah.
So, yeah, New Year's kiss. You guys going to...
Yeah.
Can we get a little preview, maybe?
Oh.
We haven't practiced yet, but we'll do it for you.
All right.
Let's work on that.
I love it. All right. Now to everyone back home, let's get a Happy New Year on three. One, two, three.
My wish for the new year is good health, strength in these hard times, and perhaps a chin lift.
My New Year's wish is for happiness and good health for everyone.
My wish for the new year is a peaceful world for my daughter.
I wish for empathy, compassion, and tacos.
My New Year's wishes are for more love, compassion, and listening in the world. Happy New Year!
I'm feeling a lot of recurring themes here tonight in regards to parents bringing their children to New Year's Eve in Times Square. What's your name, hon?
Marianela.
And your name?
Stephanie.
And so mom brought Stephanie to Times Square for New Year's Eve. What made you want to be here this year?
Well, everything here is great. I love it. I think I want to live here.
And what's the most exciting thing you've done in New York City since you've been here?
Well, I just got here today, so this has been the most exciting thing I've done.
What are you looking forward to tonight the most?
This has been the most exciting thing I've done.
What are you looking forward to tonight the most?
The new year.
The new year. Do you have any New Year's resolutions you want to share?
Work out? I guess, yeah.
You're like 20 pounds wet. What do you need to work out for?
I need to get bigger.
And what about you, Mom? Any New Year's resolutions?
I need to work out, too.
Oh, it seems another recurring theme, working out. I'm going to work out, too. How about that?
Okay,
how about
right
on the count of three, we're all going to yell a great big Happy New Year's to the camera. One, two, three. Happy New Year!
A military salute to honor our armed forces.
The United States Army. In World War I, 4,057,101 soldiers served valiantly on the field of battle. To all the men and women of the Army, our salute.
First to fight for the right and to build the nation's might, and the army goes rolling along. Proud of all we have done, fighting till the battle's won, and the army goes rolling along. And it's high, high, hey, the army's
23,466 men and women answered the call to protect our country. To every member of the Navy on every battlefront, we salute you.
Anchors away, my boys, anchors away. Farewell to homage, joys we sail at break of day. Hey, hey, hey. Through our last night on shore, drink to the fall. Until we meet once more, here's wishing you a happy voyage home.
The United States Coast Guard. During the Korean War, 44,143 members of the Coast Guard fought bravely for our freedom's preservation. To the many generations of Coast Guard veterans, our gratitude and our salute.
We're always ready for the call. We place our trust in.
Corps. During the Vietnam War, 794,000 Marines served their country with valor and honor. To every member of the Marine Corps who served in every conflict, we salute you.
From the halls of Montezuma to the shores of Tripoli, we will fight our country's battles in the air, on land, and sea. We fight for right and freedom, and to keep our honor clean. We are proud to claim the title of United States Marines.
The United States Air Force. During the Persian Gulf War, 50,751 Air Force pilots put their lives on the line for our freedom. To all the men and women of the Air Force who continue to serve their country,
we go into the wild blue yonder, climbing high into the sun. Here they come, swimming to meet our thunder. Atom boys, give her the gun. Down we dive, spouting our flame from under. Off with one hell of a roar. We live in vain, or go down in flames, where nothing can stop the U.S. Air Force.
A huge thank you to the USO Show Troop, and Happy New Year to our armed forces at home and abroad. Thank you.
Hello, Times Square. Please welcome the co-hosts of Fox News Channel's All-American New Year, Kimberly Guilfoyle and Eric Bolling. Welcome back.
It's great to be back.
Great to be here. We're so excited. Last year was amazing, and we're super excited to top it this year.
That's right. You guys are well aware of this awesome tradition we have here in Times Square. All year, people from around the world come to Times Square. They write their wish for 2017 on a piece of confetti. So at midnight, when that confetti floats down, they're actually people's wishes. So we'd love for you to guys help us and read some of the wishes that people contributed.
There's a wish for you, KG.
Okay. So let's see. This is Ivy. To be at the NBA by 2017 and...
marry my love.
Wow.
In Houston, Texas.
That is a great wish. That is the sound of the Toshiba countdown. Everybody, please count down with us. 3, 2, 1. Now that the blindfolds are off, let's go back to Sean on the Kiss stage.
Thanks, Allison. We're back with Lisa and her three guys for another Kiss, this time without the blindfolds, and we're one step closer to new love in the new year. How's everyone feeling? Are you ready for round two? All right, so Lisa, now that the blindfolds have been taken off, are there any surprises?
Oh, number two is so cute.
Oh, but these guys are so cute too, right?
They are super cute. Yeah.
They are so cute. But now we're going to kiss them without the blindfold. And then you have to select two to go on a date in the VIP lounge. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, so number one, come on over here. All right, what's your name?
I'm Chris.
Chris, is this the craziest thing you've ever done?
The craziest thing.
All right, so guys, we want to see some magic without the blindfolds. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, ignite! Yes! Woo! Wow! Good stuff, Chris. All right, come on over. Good work. All right, are you ready for number two?
Let's do it.
Come on over, number two. Hi, what's your name?
I'm Michael.
Michael, so did you have a good New Year's Eve kiss last year?
Last year? No, not really.
Are you good? Going for a good one this year, right?
Definitely.
All right, so let's make it happen, guys. Let's count it down. 3, 2, 1, make out, come on. Whoa! Dip and everything. That is like the Times Square kiss, which is crazy. High five. All right. Michael, stand over here. How was that?
That was great.
Great. We have one more kiss. Come on over, number three. And what's your name?
Garen.
Garen, very common name. Okay. All right. So I'm going to see some magic. You've seen these guys. Let's do it. Ready? 3, 2, 1, magic! Alakazam! Whoa! What? Wow! Thank you, number three. Okay, now Lisa, this is the moment of truth. Which two do you want to go on a speed date with at our VIP party?
Hard choice. Number two and number three.
Number two and number three. Oh my gosh, congratulations. I'm sorry, number one, but you have plenty to choose from out there. So guys, we'll be back in an hour to see how the dates went and see who Lisa wants to kiss at midnight with Kiss Bang Love.
ball, please welcome Tom Brennan of Waterford Crystal.
Thank you, Alison. The theme of 2017 Waterford Times Square New Year's Eve Ball is the gift of kindness, a global sentiment that promotes unity, understanding, and togetherness. As a fourth gift in our greatest gift series, it feels especially relevant and important as we look towards the start of a new year. This spirit of kindness is reflected in the design of the 288 new Waterford crystals that adorn this year's ball. It is also reflected in each of us. As we ring in the new year together, tonight our hope is that the gift of kindness inspired each of us to awaken our innate spirit of charity and compassion. The Dalai Lama once said, "Be kind whenever possible. It is always possible." Happy New Year from Waterford Crystal, and cheers to 2017 and the kindness gifts within us all.
I love
cheers,
that.
Everybody.
Cheers. Beautifully said, Tom, and a Happy New Year filled with kindness for all of us.
Thank you so much, Alison.
Thank you. Cheers.
That champagne is lovely.
Who's happy to be here? That's the energy you should have for New Year's Times Square. Now, I'm excited to meet these people. Let's see. What's your name? Where are you from?
Mariana from Mexico.
Mexico.
Woo! From Mexico.
Mexico again.
From Japan.
Japan.
Yeah. Japan.
All right.
Yeah.
You want to switch scarves? I like that scarf.
Yeah.
I can have it?
I
can have it? She's not giving it to me. See her? She's saying no. She's saying no. All right. So what were you doing last year at this time for New Year's?
What?
Were you here last year or were you in Japan?
I'm in Japan.
In Japan. Yeah. Is here better?
Yeah, so better.
See, it's so much better. You should come and hang out with us. It's a party. So what do you want for 2017?
More traveling.
More what?
Traveling.
Where do you want to go?
Everywhere.
She wants to go to Japan. You see that?
Yeah.
Look at that. Friends. Now they're friends over here. So tell us, what do you want to say goodbye to from 2016? What do you want to say bye to?
I don't know. I don't know.
Or what do you want for 2017?
New experience.
New experiences. Yeah. They're coming your way. I see it. So how has today been so far?
Good. Really good.
It's been fun, right?
Yeah.
And what's your name? Where are you from back then?
Rebecca from Tifton, Georgia.
You got Georgia in the house.
New York.
New York.
Yes.
So is anyone you want to say Happy New Year's to?
Yeah, Mom. Happy New Year.
New Year's, Mom. All right, on three. Look at this camera. It's Happy New Year, okay? One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
I am loving this energy. You guys are amazing. So we have a group here. I know some of you are in the Army. Tell me the story of this.
Well, this is my brother, and this is his brother-in-law, and they came all the way down here from Arizona, and we're from Pennsylvania. This is actually our first time here at Times Square.
And how are you liking it so far?
We love it. It's amazing.
Woo! Okay, and I understand that you want to say something to someone back home who's watching.
We want to say happy birthday to my grandmother, Rosa Mendoza, in Arizona, in Sierra Vista, Arizona.
Yeah!
Happy birthday, Mom.
Happy birthday.
So cool. She gets to celebrate on New Year's Eve. What is your favorite part about being here in Times Square?
The rush is like amazing. Everyone's like positive energy here. Everyone's like so friendly and happy to help. Like, I love it here.
Is there anyone you're really excited to see? Because you guys have pretty good spots and I'm walking by.
I think just the ball dropping in general. Like, I'm just so excited and thrilled.
And it's really right there.
Yeah!
Amazing.
We got VIP!
What is your wish for this new year?
To prosper and just to receive as many blessings from God as possible.
Love that.
Will you? Our next base is amazing, hopefully. California, next base!
Do you know when you're gonna go or where?
Monterey, California. My husband's going to DLA, so
all right.
Hopefully it's good.
Yes. All right, well, I want everyone to give a Happy New Year on three. We'll do Happy New Year and Happy Birthday.
Yeah,
ready? One, two, three.
Happy New Year! Happy Birthday!
One of the coolest things about being in Times Square for New Year's Eve are all the signs that you see. People put tons and tons of time into these homemade personal signs, and I saw this sign and just had to stop. I have no idea who Ryan Seacrest is, but I'm about to find out. What's your name, honey?
My name is Alex.
Alex.
Yes.
And what made you want to make this sign? What is it about Ryan Seacrest? I do know who that is, by the way. That was a total joke. What is it about Ryan Seacrest that draws you to him?
Just a really cool dude. Big American Idol fan, and it's awesome to be here to see him live.
And so you told me that he actually came up to you?
He did. He actually waved with me, and we were on TV and everything.
So did you get a selfie?
I did not.
You didn't get a selfie?
No, it was on TV. I didn't want to get in trouble.
And your name?
Alex.
And where are you from?
Colorado.
Why don't you look into that camera and tell everybody back home in Colorado a great big Happy New Year's. Ready?
Happy New Year,
Happy
everybody!
New Year!
Times Square, we're less than 3 hours away from midnight, and we've still got so much more. Times Square New Year's Eve is proud to present Gavin DeGraw on the Planet Fitness stage.
I don't need to be anything other than a specialist sign. I don't have to be anyone other than both the two souls in one. Part of where I'm going is knowing where I'm coming from. And I don't want to be anything other than what I've been trying to be lately. All I have to do is sink me that peace of mind. Surrounded by liars everywhere I turn. Surrounded by imposters everywhere I turn. Surrounded by identity crisis everywhere I turn. Am I the only one who noticed? I can't be the only one who's learned. I don't want to be anything other than what I've been trying to be lately. Everyone's attention, please. If you're not locked this in there, you're gonna have to leave. I came from the mountain, the crust of creation. My whole situation made from clay to stone. What I've been trying to be lately. All I have to do is think of me, out of peace of mind. I'm tired of looking around, I'm wondering what I gotta do.
supposed to be. I don't wanna be anything other than me.
So much. We got a couple more for you, Times Square. Let's get down, fellas. New York, baby. Where I have to go to see your beautiful face anymore. I stare at a picture of you and listen to the radio. Hope there's a conversation. We both admit we had it good. But until then, it's alienation. I know that much is understood. And I realize if you ask me how I'm doing, I would say I'm doing just fine. I will lie and say that you're not on my mind. But I go out and I sit down at a table set for two. And finally I'm forced to face the truth. No matter what you say, I'm not over you. Hey! Not over you. And damn girl, you do it well. And I thought you were innocent. This heart and put it through hell. But still get magnificent. I'm a boomerang. Doesn't matter how you throw me. Turn around. But I'm not even close without you. If you ask me how I'm doing, I would say I'm doing just fine. I will lie and say that you're not on my mind. But I go out and I sit down at a table set for two. If I had the chance to be new, you know there isn't a thing I wouldn't do. I could get back on the right track, but only if you'd be convinced. So until then, if you ask me how I'm doing, I would say I'm doing just fine. I would lie. Not over you.
I'm enjoying it. Y'all ready for the last one?
Everybody knows she's a perfect 10. And I'm hanging on tight till the whole thing ends. 'Cause New York sky don't get much brighter. She said, it's a city on fire. Somebody told me, if I'm not careful, well, this one's gonna roll me. I got my answer and this one's gonna own me and control me. I'm so mystified. She caught the last train last night, left another note saying, see you next time. Miss me if you don't. You look good in your bed till we meet again. You went to my head, knew they told me so. Everybody knows she's a perfect 10. And I'm hanging on tight till the whole thing ends. 'Cause New York sky don't get much brighter. She said, it's a city on fire. She said, it's a city on fire. While the cops talk, make you feel like a boss when your eyes lock and you can't stop staring in the sea. She got the whole thing figured out, hits me where it hurts, and I know I mind swinging at the curve. I don't mind it though, when the lights are low, she could hit the nose. Wearing my t-shirt, everybody knows she's a perfect 10.
Thank you.
friends, right?
We are best friends.
And what are your names?
Katie Kress.
And Brittany Perez.
And how did you meet and where?
We met at work a couple years ago.
And how did you know you were going to be best friends?
We just hit it off right away.
Now I see you have the sign at DNCE, so I'm assuming you're big fans.
Oh
why
gosh.
Do you love them?
They are just so amazing. We're obsessed.
Their songs are amazing.
Do you have a favorite song?
But the one that you mentioned, By the Ocean.
Cake All by the Ocean, yes. Now what would you do if they walked by right now?
Oh my gosh, we would die. Be so excited. We would be so excited.
No, but really, if they wanted to talk to you or something, what would you even say to them?
I would scream. I don't know. I would hug them.
Well, I hope for everyone's sake that they walk by able to get a hug or something.
Yes.
So what are people back in Florida doing right now?
It's actually pretty cold, but it has been in the high 80s, so all of our friends were at the beach.
Okay, little different, but they're not in Times Square.
No.
All right, well, for everyone back in Florida and everyone watching, let's get a big Happy New Year on three. One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
Master Artisan of Waterford. Hello, how are you doing?
I'm wonderful, Andrea. How are you this evening? What a spectacle we're at.
This is amazing,
oh
right?
My God.
This is where we're on top of the
this
world
never
right
gets
now.
Old. You know, I do this every single year for Waterford. It never gets old. Never.
Yeah, and so you make the whole thing happen. I mean, the ball is your creation. Now, you actually brought this triangle,
so tell
me about this.
Sure, this is one of the panels from the Times Square ball, the Waterford ball. So a little few facts about the ball itself, okay? There's 2,688 of these panels. It weighs 6 tons in weight on a reinforced floor. It has 32,000 LEDs behind the Waterford crystals.
Okay.
1 billion people across the world watch this. And this year's theme, this year's gift from Waterford is the gift of kindness. And that's what you're seeing right here.
I love that. If
feels really cool just to be
it
a part of it.
Yeah. I love holding it all night
long.
I know.
I want to borrow it. So cool. Maybe not give it back.
So how do you choose the theme every year?
Okay, well, as part of the Greatest Gift series, the 10-year series, and each year we introduce a brand new theme. So it ends in 2023 with the gift of love. So this amazing sphere, this Waterford crystal ball right behind us, is going to have almost like a quilt work pattern of all different themes, different emotions, different aspirations that everybody can relate to, and all designed in Waterford, Ireland.
So amazing.
It's amazing.
And so you designed things for the US presidents. You've done a lot of stuff. What makes New Year's Eve and designing the ball so amazing?
You know, what's special about this is you're right about that. I mean, we you know, connoisseurs, collectors, designers the world over, they seek out our brand. But tonight's all about celebration. Tonight's all about everybody here. Tonight's about being with your loved ones, celebrating the moment, and of course, living a crystal life.
I love that. And how is it different in New York City than Ireland?
Well, you know what, in Ireland we're 5 hours ahead, so they've already had the celebrations. But you know what, they're all crazy people anyway, so they're still out watching this. But you know, but being in New York, the crossroads of the world, this is where this was meant to be. I mean, the first ball, it actually dropped in 1907, and here we are in 2016, about to go into 2017, still celebrating, and Waterford's association with the Times Square ball goes back 17 years. We've got such a great collaboration, great friends with the Times Square Alliance, and many years to come.
Wow, amazing. I'll probably just have to, you know, take it from you?
If you break it, you buy it. That's what we say. The whole team will look and go, no, you can't have it.
All right, well, I hope you have a happy new year. Let's give a happy new year to everyone back home.
One,
two, three, happy new year. Mwah.
Global Citizen is the official... Global Citizen is the official charity partner of New Year's Eve in Times Square. Here they are with an inspirational look back at 2016.
The only festival that you can get into only by doing service, only by being a better person.
I look out and I see a sea of global citizens.
I'm committing right now that the UK will get 6.5 million more girls through school over the next 5 years.
Climate change is occurring on all of our continents and in all of our seas.
Toilet bowl companies have collectively committed over $15 million, which will serve over 130 million people.
So if I could trade jobs with anybody in the world, it would probably be this guy. Listen to this. I went all the way to the top of Times Square to meet Jeff Rolfe, the man in charge of the pyrotechnics for New Year's Eve. I am so excited to share you guys with this. Check it out.
What's up, Jeff? How are you tonight?
Very good. How are you doing?
All right, explain to I'm doing great. I'm a little nervous. Like, explain to everyone where we are right now.
We're on top of One Times Square. We're in our pyro room.
We're in the pyro room. Look at all this stuff next to me. What is this stuff, Jeff?
This is each a location for each of the signs for the pyro that will go off. Goes off at midnight for the shows.
Now, what does it take to put together a show like this? Because they go off, the fireworks go off every hour on the hour, pretty much.
Go off every hour on the hour, plus the ball raising, plus sponsor hits, and a whole bunch of other events. There's about like 20 shows throughout the night that we do.
And you guys get to test it ahead of time, or how does that work?
There's no testing ahead of time. This is all done the day of the show, and that's it.
So what's it like, that moment when you're like, okay, we're going to push the button for the first time to launch the first fireworks? Like, what goes through your head at that moment?
I don't know what goes through my head, but it's stressful. Very stressful.
Just like, I hope this works. I really hope this works.
Definitely hope it works. Just hope all the hard work that we've done, because it starts planning in, like, February to have it all happen. Comes down to that last minute, and you just really hope that
pray it works.
Pray that the weather's been good. Pray that everything we've done is all right, and it's a lot. It's a lot of, we run like 7 miles worth of wire, so there's a lot that can go wrong, and It's
like, how do you even start to even like plug all that in? Is it all run by a computer or how does it work?
It's run by a computer panel and then it's all fired individually, unfortunately, by my hand.
Unfortunately, you push a button to make the fireworks. Come on, Jeff. No.
Just like that.
Can I push it?
Yep.
This it's like a game. Wait, is it plugged in?
Yeah, it's turned off.
Okay, are you sure? This is insane.
You'd press this back and then when you pull the trigger.
When I pull the trigger,
it would go off.
Okay, we're good. This is insane. There's like two people with like the most power in the world, and I would think it's you and the guy that drives Air Force One. Like that hand power, just like this is insane.
I don't know about that, but it's close.
It's pretty powerful.
Yeah, it works.
All right, what's your favorite part about doing all of this?
The end?
It being over.
When it's all over and you hear everyone screaming and everyone having a good time, yeah, that's the best part.
We can
actually breathe. That's right. The other part. When it's all over, we can breathe.
I'm sure everyone out there is breathing right now because they are so excited and so cold probably, but they cannot wait to see the fireworks. Now, Jeff, do you have any New Year's wishes for anyone?
I don't know. Probably just, you know, for all of our military and all of our police and fire that, you know, for all the stuff they do, just great job and, you know, happy that they do and let us have the life we have. So,
yeah. Well, Happy New Year to you, Jeff. I hope it's a blast. Get it? A blast? All right, no, bad joke. All right, back to you, Jonathan.
It's a party. Is it a party? Are we having fun? Who's having fun? Come on. What's your names? Where are you from?
I'm Kanako from Japan.
Japan?
Yeah.
Japan?
Japan?
Japan, this whole crew, Japan. What did you do last year for New Year's?
Last year, I was in my home, just spend time. Yeah,
what's it like this year?
Yeah, so awesome.
This could be awesome. You can come here as well. That's right.
Yeah.
Awesome.
It is awesome. You guys should be with us. Come on down to meet some people. Hello. How you doing?
Yay.
How you doing? What's your names? Where are you from?
Latifa. From
where?
Saudi Arabia. I'm from Czech Republic.
From where?
Czech Republic.
Mom,
Saudi Arabia. Bayan, Saudi Arabia.
Oh my gosh, we have Czech Republic, the whole world. Did you all know each other?
We're sisters.
Sisters. Yeah. Of course. Look at these faces. Which one of you said New York City? You.
Yeah.
Why?
I mean, it's New York.
Is this what you expected from watching it on TV?
No, it's better.
It's better, you see?
Yeah.
Do you understand? You could meet these girls if you were here right now. Don't you wish? Get on a plane, a train,
you
trust me.
A lot.
You missed it all. So are you girls single? She is single. This could be New Year's. You at home could be kissing her. And hello. Hi, everyone. How you doing? We're in New York City.
All right.
Hi, Mom. All right. Look at that camera. On three, say Happy New Year. One, two, three.
Happy New Year.
New Year's Eve is not just about looking ahead, but reflecting on where we've been. Let's look back at the moments in 2016 that will shape our history. Courtesy of the Associated Press.
It's so surreal to me. It still hasn't hit me.
I've been going to games since I was in my mom's tummy. This means everything to me.
I am done competing, but by no means is this mean that it's the end of my career. It's the start of something new.
I just wish that we could find a way to have positive dialogue.
Really, all we want is to be policed the same way everybody else is policed.
We're hurting. Our profession is hurting. Dallas officers are hurting.
This is not just a bathroom bill, but it's a bill to our civil rights.
We're out here because a pipeline is threatening the rights of indigenous people.
These are purely people who have been uprooted and had to leave their homes and communities because of recent conflict.
The biggest thing they have is they're afraid. They've been 2 years under ISIS.
I'm absolutely confident that ISIL will lose. We will prevail.
We've got to learn to actually love each other. There's too much hate in this world. It's not fair to come together under tragic circumstances.
Looking like an idiot, holding in the phone, catching all these Pikachus and Charizards.
We're gonna free up people to do things that are higher value. There's gonna be amazing new ways of working that don't exist yet.
When I'm talking about Zika to you today, I'm not talking about something that's happening halfway around the world. I'm talking about something that's happening where we live.
Brexit means Brexit, and we're going to make a success of it.
Voters here in Iowa are sent to begin the process of selecting the next president.
We will make America great again.
First time in our nation's history that a woman will be a major party's nominee.
In a stunning victory that shocked the nation, billionaire businessman Donald Trump won the U.S. presidential election.
To all the little girls who are watching this, never doubt that you are valuable and powerful.
Now it's time for America to bind the wounds of division.
We're not Democrats first. We're not Republicans first. We are Americans first.
You can spend time going back and forth, but it doesn't change anything. The results are still the same. But you can make a difference yourself by how you treat people and how you deal with people.
Senior Vice President of Marketing for Planet Fitness. How are you? Nice to see you again.
You too. I'm just as excited to be here this year as I was last year.
I know. So you guys have a lot of great musicians and you all this great talent you pull together. What is the process picking who you're going to have every year?
Oh, wow. It is actually, the process starts in about March.
Okay.
And we work very closely with Dick Clark Productions and with Times Square Alliance, and we put it all together in a collaborative effort.
And who are you most excited for this year?
I'm most excited for DNCE, who's coming up next.
They're getting ready right behind us. We're very excited. And do you have any personal traditions that you do for the new year?
Well, the past couple years I've been here, so I think that's the new tradition. And I do. My husband's Puerto Rican, and we eat 12 grapes every New
you
Year's
do.
Eve. We do. 12 good months of luck for
yeah.
the year.
And so Planet Fitness, all about judgment-free zone,
right.
judgment-free. So, you know, how do you hope to have a judgment-free 2017?
Well, I think for me personally, I really want kindness in the new year. I'm really looking forward to everybody being kinder to people. I think if we go into 2017 with that attitude, it'll be good for everybody.
Yeah, and hopefully we can all do that. So, you know, new year, everyone has that resolution of getting back in shape.
Yeah.
What are your tips for approaching that with a healthy attitude and actually
yeah.
doing it instead of just eating all the leftover chips after the New Year's Eve party tonight?
Exactly. Well, we'll do that too.
Okay, fine. We'll do that.
But then, you know what? Just set small goals for yourself. And for a lot of people, I mean, fitness is an evolution. So sometimes your goal for the day may just be to get out of bed and get your tennis shoes on. And that should be okay. I think at Planet Fitness, we're really about being judgment-free and working at your own pace. And if you set those small goals for yourself, you tend to get there a lot faster.
All right. Well said. Well, thank you so much. Nice
thank
to see you,
you
again.
You
and
too.
Have a happy new year.
You as well.
Happy new year.
We've got some new friends from
Mississippi.
Mississippi, which I learned as MISSI SSI PPI, but you learned it as
MI, crooked letter I, humpback I.
No idea what that means, but it sounds good to me. I like that. What's your name, hon?
Pam Johnson.
And who are these beautiful women next to you?
My beautiful daughters, Jennifer and Jamie.
Now, what made you all want to spend New Year's Eve in Times Square this year?
The bucket list.
I've heard that a lot tonight.
Yes,
bucket list.
Bucket list.
Check it off. Now, what were you doing last year for New Year's Eve?
I was sitting at home watching it on TV.
Oh, well, this is so much better, right?
Yeah.
Any New Year's resolutions you want to share?
Hopefully meet a husband.
You heard it. You heard that. Meet a husband. Well, good luck with that. On the count of three, a great big Happy New Year. One, two, three. Happy New Year!
Each year, 1 ton confetti wishes are hand-delivered to the buildings in Times Square. Every hour, confetti cascades down, complete with fireworks. I mean, no one quite does confetti like Times Square. Take a look.
It was absolutely amazing. Despite the rain, gravity worked. The confetti flew just like it was supposed to. And this year we actually added a marching band, the Judgment Free Band. They were spectacular. They added a whole new level of energy, you know, to the feel here. It was great.
Drum roll, please.
It is funny. because we are, there are just a few of us up there throwing the confetti, and you see it just showering everyone over their heads with all the confetti. It's hysterical. People are laughing, dancing in it. It's really funny. Was an amazing group of kids. They're the Marching Cobras, and we made them into the Judgment Free Band for today. And this is a group of 14 kids from ages 4 to 21, and this is a musical group that comes together to teach leadership and development to kids. And all the kids represented today were from the New York area, and they were spectacular. To be here in Times Square on New Year's Eve. You stand up on that podium and look around, and all you see are the purple and yellow hats as far as you can see. It is truly spectacular. And this year, the hats are even better. We've added lights to them. So the Planet Fitness purple and yellow hats now have lights. So I think the view this year is going to be even better.
My most favorite people of the night, and probably one of the most important people in the square, Mr. Tom Harris. Tom, tell everybody at home what it is that you do here.
Peter, I work for the Times Square Alliance, and I work with the folks behind me. We make sure that Times Square is clean, safe, and a desirable place for all to come tonight.
So tell me about how large a team are you talking about here as far as what it is that you guys do?
We have a 50-person public safety team and a 70-person sanitation team that works 365 days to make Times Square an attractive place for all who visit.
What kind of preparations do you have to do? What kind of prep goes into an evening like this?
So we started preparing for next year yesterday. We sort of look at what happens, what we could do better, and we're always looking to improve it. So that's why every year when the million people come, they have a memorable experience.
Any New Year's resolutions for 2017? I complimented you before, and I don't want to throw you on the spot, but you look fantastic, Tom.
Thank you. So do you, Peter.
Peter, that's not my name.
It's not your name?
You should tell everyone at home what your secret is as far as getting in shape and losing weight.
I eat for one, and I exercise for two.
Ooh, I like that. You should get that on a T-shirt. Yeah. Now, you got some special people standing behind you here. I want to talk to them and get their names, and I'll come right back to you. Your name, sir?
Jermaine, Operations Public Safety.
Brandon, Public Safety Officer.
Hector, Public Safety.
PSO Jackson, 16 years.
16 years!
Valerio, Public Safety Officer, 3 years.
Lisa Ringo, Assistant Supervisor of Times Square, 16 years.
Brian Hester, Field Supervisor, Times Square Alliance.
Tyree Abernathy, Public Space Manager.
Damian Santucci, Director of Operations and Production.
That is quite a team, and this is only a footprint of the crew that you have. Tell me, is there anywhere else in the world that you would rather be on New Year's Eve?
There's no place. This is the place to be. A billion people worldwide wish that they were here, and a million people are here, and this is the place that I want to spend the rest of my life on New Year's Eve.
Well, it's great to have you. It's great to have you guys all here with us. Happy New Year to you. Thank you for joining us. Anybody back home you want to say Happy New Year to?
My wife, my daughter, my son, and my niece and nephews.
On the count of three, a great big Happy New Year. 1, 2, 3, Happy New Year!
On Earth this year.
I wish for peace on Earth.
My wish this year is for a magical puppy that's blonde, that stays small, but is not too small and not too large and never sheds. In the new year, everyone should accept everyone for who they are.
I wish for compassion, acceptance, and love. How about you?
I wish for wisdom, independence, success, and health.
Our wish is that in spite of a lot of hatred going on in this country,
we'd like to let love shine. Woo! Happy New Happy Year!
The technology is freaking me out. I've been hosting this show for 27 years, and now people are Facebook Living. And this random gentleman just handed me his phone and said he was Facebook Living. And it looks like Christopher Phillips joined. So, hello, Christopher Phillips. And Ricky Hodges just joined. Hello, Ricky Hodges. Happy New Year. I don't know who else. Oh, look. Oh, now we're getting some big numbers. We're up to 275. Craig Smith. Happy New Year, Craig Smith. Matthew McCarrick. It's that guy's phone. It's that guy's phone right there. Look at all these people. It's blowing up. It's blowing up. Happy New Year, everybody, wherever you are tonight.
Times Square, please welcome to the countdown stage Fumio Ohtani, Chairman and CEO of Toshiba America, and Bill Nye, the science guy. This is awesome.
Welcome. Yeah, it's good to see you, Allison, yes. Again, and I'm so excited to celebrate the New Year's Eve with my family in Times Square.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Allison. It's great to be here. It's great to be back. This is so exciting. These 2 million people coming together. It's an optimistic view of the future.
I love this. So, Bill, I understand that you and Toshiba, you guys go way back in terms of supporting science education. Tell us more about that.
Well, this is the Explorer Vision Award that I got involved with 14 years ago, but this is our 25th anniversary.
Wow, that is incredible.
And Explorer Vision, if you're not familiar with it, starts in kindergarten, goes all the way through high school, and it's the only program I know of that starts that young. Everybody who works in science and engineering today got excited about when they were real young. And you have to work in a team. You have to come up with an idea for an invention you think will come into existence in the next 20 years so that together we can, dare I say it, change the world.
I love that. That's incredible. So, Fumio, why did Toshiba create Explorer Vision? And how and why do you guys continue to support this important program?
Well, Allison, our world is changing from climate change to the food and water shortage. And Explorer Vision engages young minds to create solutions to tackle with the real world problems.
Right.
And we want to ensure that the U.S. remains competitive on the global stage by fostering the next generation of scientists, engineers, and researchers here.
That's right. Here, we're all here.
That's right, we're all here. That is really impressive. I love the sound of that. And I know that this is a very special year for you.
Yeah, that's right, Allison. We are celebrating the 25th anniversary of the Explorer Vision and our impact on nearly 400,000 students.
That's really remarkable.
Almost 500,000 students have gone through this thing. It's fantastic.
That really is remarkable. And what drew you originally, Bill, to the Explorer Vision program?
Toshiba approached me. Yes. But the National Science Teachers Association judges the competition. So I've been a member of that for a long time, and I got involved in this. And as I say, what's so good about it is it starts so young and goes all the way through high school. And it's all about getting an award for your thinking about the future, for working the way real scientists work using the scientific method. And then you get a scholarship and some Toshiba hardware. It's a cool thing.
Well, let's see Explorer Vision in action. Here we go.
At Toshiba, commitment to innovation and science education are cornerstones of our company. That's why it's our mission to engage STEM students in a lifelong love of science, tech, and innovation. So for 25 years, teachers in the U.S. and Canada have welcomed Explorer Vision, the world's largest K-12 science competition, into their schools. We're laying the foundation for tomorrow's big thinkers today. Toshiba, leading innovation.
Well, that is inspiring. I mean, is there anything else you guys like to add?
Yes, together we can use the process of science to understand nature, and dare I say it, change the world.
That is my absolute favorite.
Check out exploreavision.org, everybody.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Allison.
Thank you, Allison.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, everyone.
Look at the happy balloon.
Hello, Times Square. Please welcome Jessica Correa of Planet Fitness. Welcome back, Jessica.
Thank you. It's great to be here again.
I mean, how fortunate to be here a second year in a row celebrating New Year's Eve in Times Square. What is it like?
Look around. Yeah. Look at all the purple balloons and all the purple and yellow hats, Planet Fitness colors. It's exhilarating.
We're all having the best time. We still have so much more to go. You know of this awesome tradition we have here, that people from around the world come and write their wish for 2017 on a piece of confetti. So at midnight, when all that confetti floats down, those are actually people's wishes. I love this tradition.
It's crazy.
We would love for you to share and to read some people's wishes. What is your wish for the new year?
Well, I think in 2017, I really hope for more kindness in the world.
Yes.
You know, I have two young kids, and I try to instill in them every day how to accept and respect each other and really look at people for who they are. So I think if we start out 2017 like that, we'll be in a really great place.
I'm with you. If we could start with self-love and spreading that love everywhere, positivity will reign.
Exactly.
I'm with you on that. Let's start. You want to start with the first wish?
I do. Let's look at the first wish. Drum roll, please. I took out the purple paper.
Perfect.
Of course.
How appropriate.
All right. To lose weight in 2017.
Also
Detroit, Michigan, Planet Fitness.
That's right. That's great. You are in control
your
of yourself.
Turn.
We got this. You got the power to
All
do
right.
that. Paula is saying that our daughter is born healthy and happy and has a brilliant first year of life. I love that. From Salt Lake City,
Utah.
Great. That's a beautiful wish.
All right.
Health is wealth. Health is wealth.
Okay.
I should take that one out. Yeah.
Tom wishes to get a B in math from Richmond, Virginia.
That's great. Progress, not perfection.
Right.
I support
hey,
that.
Hey, baby
okay.
steps.
Go for the A, Tom. Sandra says to be exceptionally blissful. That's gorgeous.
Oh, that's
from Seattle,
a good one
Washington.
Too.
That's
Are
right.
There any more?
You gotta
one
start
last
with gratitude.
One. All right. Stephanie would like to meet the cast of Stranger Things from Raleigh, North Carolina. All right. It's quite the wish.
I would like to meet the cast too. It's one of the best shows of the year.
I know, it's fabulous.
All right, let's see if we have time for one more.
Do we have any more?
Anna, for our country and the world to overcome this scary time and to find what fulfills me. That's beautiful. From Bristol,
Absolutely.
Connecticut, Tri-State Area Represent. What's up, Anna? I love that one. Thank you so
All right.
much.
I think. Up.
That is the sound of the Toshiba countdown. We would love for everybody to join in and count down with us. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now at the Planet Fitness stage, Univision presents Lupio Rivera.
Buenas noches. ¡Viva México! Alegres para la mujer, su nombre era Dolores. Dolor siempre vivió y aún pudo lograr. Enfrentó la guerra, peleó como fiel, ganó y triunfó en todas las batallas. Inolvidable será. Sus heridas con puro tequila hizo lo que quiso aquí en esta vida. Espero que mucho su ejemplo lo siga. Fue la gran señora por siempre la diva. Dolores se llamaba. Abusos, maltratos y golpes también. El que dijo amarla un infierno fue. Dolor que pudo vencer. Peleando Dolores sanó sus heridas con puro tequila. Hizo lo que quiso aquí en esta vida. Espero que mucho su ejemplo lo siga. Es la gran señora por siempre la viva.
Pan la paca, qué bonito se menea, orgullosa cubana, cómo bate sus caderas. Una bella mujer con su cuerpo de Dios, su corta mini falda siempre es mucho más hermosa. Ella me pone a temblar, ella me pone a soñar, con ese cuerpo de diosa se ve espectacular. Yo la quisiera abrazar, yo la quisiera besar, pero con esas caderas prefiero verla bailar. Con el gran ritmo que tiene esa paca, todo se me acelera. El habla se me va, ah, ah, le pone ganas, le echa adrenalina y la gente se arrima para verla bailar. Es lista pa' la placa, qué bonito se menea, orgullosa cubana, cómo bate sus caderas. Una bella mujer con su cuerpo de diosa, su corta minifalda siempre es mucho más hermosa. Ella me pone a temblar, ella me pone a soñar, con ese cuerpo de diosa se ve espectacular. Yo la quisiera abrazar, yo la quisiera besar, pero con esas caderas prefiero verla bailar. Con el gran ritmo que tiene esa placa, todo se me acelera, el habla se me va.
un conductor diario por toda la televisión. Y todos le gritan el gordo. Desde niño el chisme le gustó, a buscar noticias se dedicó. Y ahora todos le huyen al gordo. No importa el trabajo que escogió, siempre es amigo de honor. Ser orgullo hispano ya lo logró. Nada más, así su esposa lo adora y no puede estar sin su gordo. Ya trato de rebajar ese gordo, ya ha bajado libras así y todos adoramos al gordo. Su personalidad es así, ha ganado todos los premios que existen, ya todo nos hace feliz. El Raúl de Molina, el gordo. No importa el trabajo que escogió, siempre es amigo de honor. Ser orgullo hispano ya lo logró, el famoso gordo. Un minuto aguanta nada más, así su esposa lo adora. Y no puede estar sin su gordo. Ya trato de rebajar ese gordo, ya ha bajado libras así. Y todos adoramos al gordo, su personalidad es así. Ha ganado todos los premios que existen, ya todo nos hace feliz. Es Raúl de Molina, el gordo. Es Raúl de Molina, el gordo.
Gracias, buenas noches. México lindo y querido, los quiero.
Around the corner, I tried to find the two coolest guys I could, but here we go. Come on, you know his face. This is Bill Nye. You know him from science and many other things. And Eddie, the king of Toshiba.
Oh, the king. I love it. I love it.
So we've done a scholarship program together for today's. This is the 25th year. I've been working on it 14 years. Largest science competition in the world called Explore a Vision. If you're out there, it starts in kindergarten, runs in four categories all the way through high school. You have to come up with an invention that you think will come into existence in the next 20 years. Prepare a website. You have to work in teams. That's a rule. If you win, you get all kinds of cool Toshiba stuff, and you get money.
A lot of
for
money.
College. We like that.
A lot of money. First place is 10,000 U.S. savings bond for each student. Second place, 5,000 U.S. savings
bond. It adds up.
That adds up to a lot, guys, for science. What's up? And how has it been working with Bill all these years, man?
It's been unbelievable.
He used to be taller. Here he is, beating him down.
Here we go. Beating him down a little bit, but I love it. I love Bill. Bill is such an advocate for science education. And we at Toshiba, our goal is to make the U.S. competitive. In order to be competitive, you have to have science education for our youngsters, and that's what we're looking to do.
Absolutely, and that's what we're talking about. And next year is 2017. What are you guys, what are some wishes you guys want for next year?
I want space missions to Mars to retrieve samples, and I want a mission to Europa, the moon of Jupiter with twice as much seawater of the Earth, to look for signs of life, which would change the course of human history. And yes, I would like us to address climate change in a big way. Yes.
Absolutely. So climate change is a real thing, Bill. People say it's a rumor. What's going on?
Only in the U.S. Only in very small. No, everybody else in the world. And Toshiba has a big power program, electric power program. They're working on Japan to make the country eventually 100% renewable. The longest journey starts with a single step.
So let's make that step happen.
We'll
so on three.
Replace natural gas with hydrogen. It's hard, but it's doable.
And if he says it's doable, you know it is. On three. Can we say Happy New Year on three? One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
We are thrilled to have Barefoot Bubbly with us tonight as the official Bubbly of New Year's Eve in Times Square. We'd like to welcome Annabelle, Barefoot's Director of Marketing, and the woman who puts the bubbles in the bottle, Barefoot winemaker, Jen Wall. What is up, ladies?
I'm so happy that you're here.
Well, we're happy to be here. We're so happy to be here. It's such a treat to be out here and see all of these faces here in Times Square. It's really amazing and overwhelming in the best possible way. At Barefoot Bubbly, we just have one simple goal. We want to make delicious bubbly that everyone can love. That's because we believe every celebration, whether it's big or small, should have a fabulous toast. You know what would make tonight even better, Jen?
What's that?
Not waiting till midnight.
I love that. Well, that's right, Annabelle. This is absolutely incredible. We're so excited to be here, ringing in the new year with all of you in this amazing city. I've watched the ball drop at Times Square for years on TV from the West Coast, and I can't believe I'm here with you tonight. And with Barefoot Bubbly celebrating with a million new friends and all these Barefoot fans, it's so exciting! Woo! Woo! Well, it's always a good time for bubbles, That's right. We just happened to have some bubbles right in front of us. So we have our Brut Cuvée and our Barefoot Bubbly Pink Moscato. So let's have a little celebratory toast.
Thank you.
Annabelle, oh, you
don't
got
mind
it.
If
perfect.
I do.
Perfect. So we hope that all of our friends at home can enjoy their own bottle of Barefoot Bubbly tonight. And let's raise a glass together for lots of fun and love in 2017. Cheers,
cheers.
Everybody.
And a happy new year to you both.
Thank you, to you too.
Delicious.
Now let's go back to Sean at the Kiss stage to see who Lisa will be kissing at midnight.
Thanks, Allison. What a toast. It's a kiss-filled night with our live version of Kiss Bang Love. We'll be doing our own celebrating in just a moment when Lisa chooses her New Year's kiss. Now, Lisa, after two rounds of kisses and the mini dates at the Hard Rock Cafe, are you closer to deciding who you want for the bald drop?
Well, I thought I was close, and then I had the mini dates, and I wasn't sure I changed my mind, so it's up in the air.
All right, so I have one last question for you guys. Okay, Garen, how old were you when you had your first kiss?
I was 12.
12? Wait, what was her name?
Ginny.
Ginny? Ginny and Garen. That's like the most different names. I love it. Are you still in contact?
No, I think I bit her nose.
Bit her Oh, wow.
I like to think it's gone better as I've gotten older.
Okay, good to know, good to know. All right, and Michael, your last question. You know, since tonight, when was your last kiss?
Last kiss is with this beautiful lady right here.
Right, but before that, who was it?
Well, it was 4 months ago.
4 months ago, so you had a dry spell and the lovely Lisa has cleared that up for you?
Yes.
All right. Wow, Lisa, these are sweet and amazing guys. I mean, after the dates and the two kisses, like, who do you want to choose? Come on! Woo! Final moments! Oh, my gosh!
I'm going to go with Michael.
Michael! Congratulations, Lisa and Michael! I'm so sorry, Garen. Maybe you shouldn't have bit her nose. Okay. So to help us celebrate, welcome back our friends from Married at First Sight. It's Jamie and Doug and Courtney and Jason. We're so glad you guys could join us. Now, let's give a preview of what's to come at midnight with a real New Year's Eve kiss. 3, 2, 1. Fireworks, like literally, guys. Oh my gosh, it has been a blast with you tonight. Watch the season premiere of Kiss Bang Love, January 3rd at 10, 9 Central on FYI. Happy New Year!
As you can see by the awesome purple hats all over the square tonight, Times Square New Year's Eve is presented by Planet Fitness. So let's go check out what's happening on our Planet Fitness stage with Jimmy Knowles.
Thank you, Allison. Happy New Year, Times Square! Welcome to the 2017 New Year's Eve halftime show brought to you by Planet Fitness. We're only an hour and a half away from 2017, so we want to keep your energy up and keep you guys excited. What do you guys say? All right, now we have a very special performance for you here tonight. Hailing from Harlem, let's give it up for the Judgment Free Marching Band! Now, before we all get our groove on, I want to take a second to introduce the band. So, let's give it up for the boys on snare! And how about my crew on bass? And last but not least, our Judgment Free dancers! All right, everybody, we've got a dance cam on all of you, so it's time to let loose and be free. Judgment Free Marching Band, let's see what you guys got.
Just watch.
Great start to your 2017, and don't forget to be free. Happy New Year, Times Square!
Maria.
Manuel.
Mari Carmen.
All right, you came all the way from España. Yay. What brings you here?
It's my father's birthday.
Yay. It's your birthday?
Yes. Yay. Yes.
Happy birthday. Yeah. How is it celebrating your birthday here?
No, not English.
That's okay, because you can.
He's turning into 50, so he's... Wish his dream was being here. That's why we are here celebrating the New Year's Eve here in Times Square.
That's amazing, and yes. Happy birthday. What is it like? Explain the atmosphere to everyone back home watching from Spain.
Oh my God, it's incredible. Secure, multicultural, amazing. Very, very awesome. Yes.
I love it.
Yes. It's incredible. The atmosphere, it's the best in Spain. We don't have these kind of things. It's really different.
All right. So for everyone back home, let's say Happy New Year in Spanish.
Yes.
So Feliz Año Nuevo.
Yes.
You got it? All right. So uno, dos, tres.
Feliz Año Nuevo.
Here with one of the lead organizers of New Year's Eve. This is the Vice President of Events and Programs for the Times Square Alliance, Gary Winkler. Gary Winkler! Thank you for joining us tonight, Gary. Now, tonight's already amazing. Is there anything for New Year's that you're really excited for tonight?
Every year there's a little something different that's going on. So this year, obviously, we had the performance earlier with JoJo Abbott. New Year, new voices, and we always talk about another star is born on Broadway every year with all the Broadway shows, of course, in the neighborhood. But at the New Year's Eve event, we really haven't had an opportunity to do something like that. So working with the different talent buyers throughout the city, the nominations, the Apollo said, here's something different, and she's here tonight, I think.
She's like a worldwide phenomenon. She came out with the hair and the makeup. She looked awesome. What do you look forward to most for this event?
Look forward to most is really getting a chance to work with the amount of people that take to put on a monstrous event like this. When you talk about over a million people coming together, there's city agencies, the mayor's office, the NYPD, which everyone talks about keeping us safe. But really, the amazing people that work behind the scenes on shows like this, these are the who's who in the industry that work the Olympics, the Super Bowl, and Times Square New Year's Eve.
Now every year you think this is as big as it can get. There's no way this can get bigger, and it does. How is that possible?
We have great partners. It starts with people like Planet Fitness. A year ago, they had 1,000 clubs. This year, there's 1,200 across the nation. They took our Confetti Wishes program, where people write their wishes on confetti that actually drops on New Year's Eve. We take them throughout the year. Planet Fitness did the same in their 1,200 clubs all around the nation, and more people are learning about what we do here in Times Square.
Now, do you have any New Year's resolutions? Because did you keep any from last year?
I made any from last year.
Okay, well, what is it going to be this?
You're going to put me on the spot now.
I know. Well, it's, come on, live television, Gary. Come on. What do you think about, what's your resolution for this year?
New Year's resolution, more time with my family.
Yep.
I got a new baby girl, so lots of time with her in 2017.
All right, well, thank you for spending so much time with us tonight, Gary. I know you're a busy man. We will see you in 2017. Now let's go out to Times Square and see what's happening with our revelers. What's up, guys?
What you have to do, here's rule number one in Times Square. Meet random people like this. Hi, how you doing? Hi. It can happen just like that. You never know. So what's your names? Where are you from?
Rainy, I'm from Canada.
Canada.
Sandra, I'm from Mexico.
Mexico.
Natalie's from Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico.
Asia, Iran.
Iran.
Danny from Virginia.
Do you see this? Oh, we have the whole map right here. Now, did you all know each other before today?
No.
Are you all friends now?
Yeah.
Do you see that, people? We're bringing the world together, one New Year's at a time. So is there anyone you want to say Happy New Year's to? Anyone? Anyone you
my
want
mom.
To talk to?
My mom! Happy New Year's, Mom!
Mom and Dad, Happy New Year!
Happy New Year to every family in Puerto Rico.
Cristalin, Puerto Rico.
All Indians, Happy New Year!
You see that, we're wishing you all joy and so much more. Now, what's today been like here in this square? What's it been like?
Cold!
And?
Cool.
And?
Very cold.
And no, you don't look cold, though. They're saying that. Look at her. She came dressed, prepared, ready. Now, it's been fun as well, meeting all these different people, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
How would you describe pretty much the energy in Times Square to someone watching at home?
I don't know.
That means fun. All right, on three, look at that camera. Say Happy New Year's, okay? One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
I told you I was going to make contact with every country in the world, and I believe I'm somewhere around halfway there. I found Canada, representing Canada. What is your name, sir?
Tim Wilson.
And who is this beautiful lady next to you?
Stephanie Wilson.
Stephanie Wilson, so I assume you're married.
We are, yeah.
Okay, how's that working out for you?
Not too bad.
Did you have a good 2016?
Yes, we did.
Now, what made you want to be in Times Square for New Year's this year?
My bucket list.
Seems to be a pretty popular statement, bucket list. Now, what do you think so far?
Awesome, just awesome.
Now, you got front row seats here right next to the main stage. What time did you get here?
11 o'clock.
Okay, so that's not horrible.
Not too bad.
It's a beautiful weather. You should have been here last year. It's a different program. Any New Year's resolutions?
Not for me.
Not one.
No.
Everything's great with this guy. What about you?
Travel lots.
I think that's a hint. You're gonna do some traveling. Okay, let's look into the camera and wish Canada a happy New Year on the count of three. One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
I'm here with Rachel Platten. How are you?
Hi, cutie. I'm good, thank you.
You're cute.
Hey.
So you just performed, and you performed Fight Song. That was amazing. Now, I know you're originally from New York, but what was it like performing here live in front of all these people?
Well, I'm from Boston. I lived in New York for like 10 years, but it was really special. I struggled really hard in the city to make it in music, and I wrote Fight Song. Wandering these streets, broke, wishing that I had more going on. So to perform it tonight in front of millions of people here, it wasn't lost on me. It was really special.
So that's kind of a crazy circle that you just took. And Fight Song is very inspirational for a lot of people, kind of hope and everything. So for New Year's Eve, what is your hope for this next year?
I made a really strange resolution that might not like work other than in my journal, but I'm going to throw it out there. It was basically to just be kinder to myself, to have a little bit more compassion. I try to be kind and giving to everybody else, and often I notice that I'm so hard on myself. And so my resolution is to kind of be grateful and present and kind of accept that things are really good and not need more, you know?
I love that. Yeah. I mean, that's really amazing. Now, in terms of your music and everything, you've had a really great past year and past couple years. What's next for you? What can fans look forward to?
I cannot wait for next year. I have an album coming out that I've been working on. I am so proud of these songs. They're the story of where I've been since the past 2 years and all the ups and downs. And just really excited for fans to get to hear it.
I love that. Well, we're definitely looking forward to that. Now, for everyone watching, let's give a Happy New Year on three. One, two, three. Happy New Year! Woo-hoo! Rachel Platten, everybody!
There's a little game you got to play after a few hours. What do you all do? What are you guys doing and what do you do?
We are United States Marines.
We got the Marines. Any other Marines right here?
Yeah, man.
Marines are strong over here. What's your names? Where are you guys from, man?
I'm Jeremy. I'm from Texas.
I knew I liked this guy. I'm Jeremy as well. My brother.
How you doing,
You Jeremy? See that? You didn't even know. You didn't know. Different mothers, though. Different moms.
Maybe not.
Whoa.
We kind of have a little resemblance.
You see that? We got the swag. What's your name?
I'm Jeremy, too, and I'm from Ohio.
Are you messing with me?
No. Nope.
Is he really Jeremy?
He's really Jeremy.
Don't tell me you both are Jeremy as well.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Scott.
Scott.
CJ.
And what's your name?
Alex.
I thought you say Jeremy. Nope, it's Alex. So whose idea for you guys was it to come here?
It was all of us, a combined effort.
And how did you guys meet?
We all work together, actually.
All right, and when you guys sitting there, you guys, let's go to New York. Let's do this thing. Is it your first time here?
Yes.
Actually.
What's it like? Well, actually, explain to people at home what it's like today, what it's been like so far.
There's been a lot of people.
Thank you.
It's really hectic, but everything's really, really fun. There's just so much to do and so much to see in the city. It's great. I'm not a big city person, but I love it here.
That's awesome. You see that? You guys could be here too. You better come next year. Now, what was the best part so far of being here today?
Well, I mean, other than being in the military, just getting up here, just, you know, being close to pretty much everything and everything is pretty fucking awesome.
It is. No, that's New York City. And so what are you guys doing in the Marines?
Us three right here, we're diesel mechanics. We work on 7-ton Humvees and pretty much any fucking vehicle you want to.
That means they fix things, people. They fix things. So what do you guys want for 2017? What do you want, man?
I just want to have some more fun.
That's the deal. What do you want over here?
Can't wait to marry this guy in April.
We're getting married?
We are.
Hold up. Let's get a preview of that midnight. I want to see a kiss in 3, 2, 1. Oh my God, do you see that? Oh, that's too much. That's too much for a kid. That's too much. That's too much. All right, on three. Happy New Year's, okay? 1, 2, 3.
Happy New Year!
Any New Year's resolutions for 2017?
To enjoy every single second the moment it's happening.
We're so glad you're here.
I'm thrilled. This is a first for me. We played 30 years ago in Dick Clark's, but we were in LA, and this is the first time in Times Square, so we're thrilled.
Thank you so much for being here. Happy New Year.
I'm right here with the president of the Times Square Alliance and co-organizer of New Year's Eve, Tim Tompkins. He is the person who runs the most famous place in the world. Tim, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for being such a great host.
Oh, hey, stop it. We haven't finished it yet. Night is still young. All right, so tell us about this year's celebration.
It's an amazing mix of people. You're going to be talking about the talent that's going on throughout the night. And then, of course, it ends with the Secretary General of the United Nations, Ban Ki-moon, who we chose because, of course, 2016 was about countries turning their backs on each other, putting up walls between each other, saying we're not going to let in immigrants or migrants, and Brexit pulling apart. So we wanted to send a message that, yes, you can turn against each other, or the nations of the world can work together to solve problems, many difficult problems. And that's what the United Nations does. It's not perfect, but it tries. And so that's the message we're sending by choosing the Secretary General as our honored guest this year.
That is just so awesome. Now, why do you think New Year's Eve Times Square gives us hope for 2017?
Well, I think, you know, some people say, why would people stand out here for like 12 hours when it's cold?
Right.
First of all, it's not that cold. This is warm this year. But the thing is that I think New Year's is about, it's about celebration. It's a party. But it's about celebrating the things and the people we love, no matter how crazy the world is. And, of course, we know the world's crazy. It's about looking back over the last year and saying, what are we going to let go of? Because we all need this sort of mental and spiritual reset of a new year. And it's about looking forward with a sense of hope. Sometimes it's a personal thing. I want my own life to be better. I want to join Planet Fitness and work out some more.
Right.
Or I want there to be peace in the world. And so it's that celebration, that reflection on where we've been, and that looking forward with a sense of hope and renewal. That's what makes people make the pilgrimage. Yeah. And people make the pilgrimage from around the world.
Yeah, there are revelers literally here from all over the entire world. I've seen people from so many different countries. What's that feel like for you? Because you're the man, bro. You are the guy that puts this on. What's it feel like to have these people come from everywhere for the event that you helped to put on?
It reminds me of what I love about New York, which is its diversity and its richness, and our country at its best celebrates diversity and all of that. And, you know, it's this woman from Costa Rica who I met earlier tonight who literally came to New York just to see and experience the ball drop. She'd seen it on TV. She made the pilgrimage here. Many people make the pilgrimage here for that reason. And also, none of it would be possible without the amazing work of the New York City Police Department that makes New York City safe, not just tonight, but all around. The fire department, the mayor's people, all those folks really make it happen. So a big shout out to the NYPD.
I mean, they are absolutely amazing. I see them everywhere tonight, working so hard, keeping us safe. Big shout out to the NYPD. Now, Tim, everyone has resolutions. Sometimes we keep them, sometimes we don't. I keep about half of mine. What are your resolutions for 2017?
I mean, mine are really with respect to the crazy world we live in these days, which is less hate, more hope, and keeping that spirit within me. Because sometimes we get down when we see what's going on in the world. And, you know, all of us have a role to play. New Year's Eve can be that reset for all of us to say, you know what, if we need to resist, we're going to resist. And if we need to love each other a little more and hate each other a little bit less as a country and as the world and all our different tribes, that's what we need to do.
You heard it from Tim himself. Less hate, more hope. That is really awesome. Tim, thank you so much for being here. I know you have really important things to do tonight. So we'll see you in 2017, and I wish you a very, very happy new year.
Happy New Year! I found this amazing family in Times Square. What are your names?
Dave.
Karen.
Maureen.
Morgan.
Nick.
All right, and Maureen, I understand it was your idea to come here for Times Square New Year's Eve. Why did you want to come here?
Because it's been on my bucket list since I was 21 years old.
Really?
So, yep.
And now that you're here, what is it like? Is it everything you ever imagined?
It's a little different. It's still fun because my family's with me. I just wish we could see stuff better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people here, definitely.
Yeah.
What are you most looking forward to in this upcoming year?
Health.
Yes. And what about you guys? For 2017, what is your wish for this new year?
Just to have a great year. I don't know.
Yeah.
Just a healthy and happy new year.
What about you?
Probably the same.
I want to get more fit.
All right, get fit. And how nice, what is it like being here with your family?
I love it. I love being with my family.
I love that.
Anywhere.
All right. All right, so for everyone back home, let's do a happy new year on three. One, two, three. Happy New Year!
Woo! You get your New Year's resolution?
Rafi says spread and love, but mine is I'm actually going to use my gym membership, but I'm probably not going to use my gym membership, but I have one. But I feel like if I use it, then I'm going to have to start with something else next year, and I like just knowing what I really need to work on.
Big plans for 2017?
I got chubby stomach, you know what I'm saying?
No,
used
you
to
look
be
great.
It used to be like more like an 8-pack, and now it's looking a lot more like a pony cake, you know what I'm saying?
Not a day
Thank
over
you,
20.
Yeah, right.
To have you here.
Nice to be here, man.
First
Appreciate
time in Times
it.
Square for New Year's Eve?
I've been here, actually, I came here about a gazillion years ago, and it was about 30 degrees colder. And it was great. And it was
balmy.
Great. Yeah, this is like Florida weather compared to what it could have been.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Break a leg tonight.
Hey, I appreciate
great
it very, very much.
Here.
Great to be had, man.
Take care.
Appreciate it very much.
Have a good one.
Guys.
Happy New Year. Gavin DeGraw.
In Times Square, I always look out and see people. Look at that pretty face right there. What's your name?
Caitlin.
Caitlin, where are you from?
San Antonio.
How are you liking New York City?
Good.
Is it the same weather as Texas? Is it? It is?
Yes.
That's why she's loving it. But it's a case. I think, do you like the color red?
Yes.
I got some. This is for you. Awesome. So now, what were some of the highlights of 2016, this year? What did you like?
Fireworks.
Fireworks always work. And now, 2017, what do you want?
Santa to come.
All right, let's make it happen. That's right. All right, anyone you want to say Happy New Year's to over there? Talk to them.
Happy New Year's, 2016.
That's right, 2017.
2017, I
think. That's right, for both years, this year and next year. All right. You been a good kid this year?
Yes.
You're going to be a better kid next year?
Yes.
What grade are you going to be in?
Fifth
grade. Are you ready for fifth grade?
Yes.
Is fifth grade ready for her? We're going to find out. All right, on three, let's say Happy New Year's, okay?
Okay.
One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
Gentlemen, it's your boy Salento. I am a Capitol recording artist, and I'm 18 from Atlanta, Georgia. And my hit single is Watch Me. Shout out to everybody watching worldwide. Let's go ahead and get this thing started. If you know how to whip and you know how to nay-nay, I want to see you do it. Let's go. You already know what it is. Salento.
Watch me, nay, nay.
Watch me, 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 watch
break your legs. Break your legs. Go on and break your legs. Break your legs. Go on and break your legs. Break your legs. Now watch me bop, 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 bop. Now watch me bop, 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 bop. Now watch me whip. Now watch me nay nay. Now watch me whip. Watch me nay nay. Now watch me whip. Watch me nay nay. Now watch me
whip. Whip. Can you do it?
Ooh, watch me. Watch me. Ooh, watch me. Watch me. Ooh, watch me. Watch me. Ooh, ooh.
Worldwide, who like the whipping nay nay? It's your boy Salento at Prince Salento on all social media. Make sure you go get my new shoes on VelatoFootwear.com. Let's go!
I'm Wesselin.
And how did you two meet?
We met at church, actually, and we used to work together.
Okay, I understand that you've been trying to come to the ball drop for a couple years, so tell me about that.
3 years. Last year, we were 2 seconds away from seeing the ball drop. 2 seconds.
Oh, my goodness. How would you even recover from that?
Oh, it was hard, but we knew we were going to make it back out here this year.
So what was your strategy this year to make it?
We were going to come early. We stayed close by. We just powered our way through.
Yeah, what time did you get here?
Oh, we didn't get down here until about 8.
Okay.
We were latecomers, but we made it.
You made it, yes. Now that you're here, what's your favorite part about being here in Times Square?
The energy. All the people. Yeah. Very friendly. Everyone's just having a great time, being very friendly with one another.
I love
just
it.
Just really good.
All right, 2017, very soon approaching. What is your wish for this new year?
Live life to the fullest. I'm going to travel as much as I want to, just be happy, live life to the fullest.
No regrets for anything.
That's amazing. That is good. Yes, well said. Let's get a big Happy New Year to everyone back home.
Right.
1, 2, 3.
Happy New Year!
If you know anything about me at all, you know I am a sucker for a man in uniform. And luckily I found here, what is your name, sir?
My name is Tyler.
And who is this beautiful woman next to you?
Her name's Erica.
Hello, Erica. I assume this is your girlfriend.
That's correct.
Fantastic. You're doing nice work.
Appreciate it.
How did you end up in Times Square for New Year's Eve this year?
I had the opportunity and wanted to come down and check it off the box.
Well, I'm glad you're here. Is this your first time in Times Square for New Year's Eve?
Yes.
What do you think so far?
It's crazy.
Well, it's great to have you here. We appreciate your service.
My pleasure.
And I hope you have a fantastic 2017.
I appreciate it.
Anybody back home you want to see Happy New Year's to?
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Happy New Year's.
What about you?
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Happy New Year's.
On the count of three, a great big Happy New Year. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Happy New Year!
Woo! Who wants to be interviewed by me? right here. Look, you just gotta be first. You gotta be quick. What's your name?
Yaresi.
Yaresi, where are you from?
Yeah, I'm from Mexico.
Mexico? Where in Mexico?
Yeah. Monterrey.
Monterrey. This where yes. you're from? Is this where you're from? Let's get a full. Viva la Mexico!
Y Colombia!
Oh my gosh! Everywhere! And where?
Brazil.
And Brazil!
Yeah.
Where else?
We are from Japan!
Japan! Anywhere else? I miss
Italia!
Italia! Where?
Venezuela!
Venezuela! I mean, the whole world is here! What'd you say?
I'm from Japan!
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 Japan. That's what I'm talking about! So for 2017, what do you want?
I don't know, maybe a better job.
She wants a better job.
Yeah.
And if she was gonna travel somewhere, should she go to Japan?
Yeah. Japan!
You know where you guys gonna go? To where?
Japan!
All right, on three, look at this camera and say Happy New Year's. One, two, three. Happy New Year's!
Japan!
Because I found a family from Wisconsin, which I am from too. What are your names?
Jeff.
Eli.
Noah.
Sarah.
Noah.
Amy.
All right, I understand it was your idea to come here. How did you get the family to get here, Times Square?
Well, I just wanted to come because it was Christmas and it always looked so cool with all the lights and everything. And they just kind of agreed to do it.
It's very different from Wisconsin, I know firsthand. What is your favorite part about New York City?
Empire State Building.
Did you go there?
Yeah.
Amazing. What about you?
I like the World Trade Center.
Okay.
Skating at Rockefeller, that was pretty fun. I like that. Yeah. Reminded me of Wisconsin. So.
The tree at Rockefeller Plaza.
Wow, you guys have done a lot already. You've definitely seen New York. Now 2017, right around the corner. What do you want to say to people back home in Wisconsin?
We miss all of you, but we wish you were here with us.
I love it.
And just have a fun time.
All right, so let's get a big Happy New Year on three to everyone back home in Wisconsin and everywhere. One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
Host of Univision's Feliz 2017, Raul de Molina, and his beautiful daughter, Mia. I love having you guys here, both of you here every single year.
Thank you. It's a pleasure being here every year, and this year especially, because we're celebrating Univision broadcasting live from Times Square for the last 20 years.
That is fantastic.
It's tradition at this point.
It's really incredible, and there is no other place in the world to be on December 31st.
Oh, I'm with you, and I'm glad that we get to do this together. And you guys know we have this beautiful tradition here that all throughout the year, people come from all around the world and write their wish for 2017 on a piece of confetti. So at midnight, when all that confetti comes down, it's actually people's wishes. So I'd love for you guys to read some of the wishes have written for us. Let's start off, Mia.
For 2017 to be filled with adventure with my best friend from Cheyenne in Wyoming.
Oh, that's
and that's
beautiful.
Jackie. Let's take another one. Let's
take another one.
Okay, it's in Spanish. You can read it.
Reinaldo, obtener buenas calificaciones en la escuela. Solamente buenas.
Fantastic.
Feliz año. Reinaldo nos dice esto.
And tell us in English as well what that means.
And really, it's
in English.
Well, that he wants to get good grades in school. That's what Reinaldo
That's
wants.
A good goal.
That's all he's wishing for, 2017. And I really want to say a few words. It's been a really tough year around the world. And one more time, I want to say thank you to all the 7,000 members of the New York Police Department that are working here tonight without their family to make this city safe and to make Times Square safe. Thank you so much.
That's right.
And also for the Latino community, it has been a very tough year during the presidential elections. And I hope, I really hope, and keep my fingers crossed, that everything turns out good for 2017.
It's gonna be
so I year. Hope everything is great for 2017.
Should we try to do
now,
more?
I wanna remember one of the greatest singers that we have that passed away this past year from Mexico, Juan Gabriel. Remembering Juan Gabriel. I don't know how many Latinos here tonight.
Go ahead, Mia.
Felicia.
There is one, Mia. Felicia. Mi matrimonio es bueno de Ponce, Puerto Rico.
That's beautiful.
And now,
we're counting down
for the new year.
That is the sound of the Toshiba countdown. Everyone, please count down with us. 3, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Happy New Year. Felicidades, Puerto Rico. Felicidades, República Dominicana. Happy New Year in Puerto Rico and in Dominican Republic. Thank you, thank you. Thank you so much. And now I'd like to introduce here who's going to be singing for all Times Square and live on Univision. He's one of the greatest singers in Latin America. You see him in the movies Fast and Furious. From Puerto Rico, they call him El Rey, Don Omar.
Gracias, Raul. New York, are you ready? I wish you a happy 2017. Let's do this. Happy 2017. Latino!
It is my honor to present a special New Year's message from the First Lady of the United States, Michelle Obama.
Good evening, Times Square, and to everyone watching around the world. I hope everyone is having a good time tonight. Now, as we prepare to ring in the new year, you've been hearing about some of the global challenges we're facing in 2017 and beyond. And one of those issues is particularly close to my heart. The fact that right now, 98 million adolescent girls worldwide are not in school. In my travels as First Lady, I have met so many of these girls, and they are so bright and so hungry to learn, but they never have that chance because their families can't afford it or their societies don't think they're worthy of an education. None of us would accept this fate for our daughters, so why would we accept it for any girl on this planet? These girls are all our girls, and we simply cannot walk away from them. So I hope that you will join me in helping girls worldwide get the education they deserve. Visit letgirlslearn.gov and commit to taking action using the hashtag #LetGirlsLearn. Make it one of your resolutions for 2017. And thanks so much. I wish you all a happy, healthy new year.
Carisha,
Jada,
Jade.
Okay, so you two are best friends, yes. Jada and Jade. Yes. That's kind of unusual.
Yeah, yes. I know. People think we're twins all the time.
Yeah, we get it a lot.
But
a
it's really cool. You have similar names. Now, your mom.
I'm mom to Jade.
And I understand you were here, what, 34 years ago?
34 years ago. It was my first time and the last time that I was here.
Okay.
I have a daughter. She's 33 years old. And the first time I came out was before she's born. I have not been back since.
But now you're back.
With my youngest.
And how is it being back? What's the biggest difference?
Oh my gosh, the whole of Times Square is different.
This, really?
The last time I was here, it was still seedy. It's no longer seedy. It's very classed up. The energy is great. It's just a lot more security to make sure that we're safe. It's still good. It's
yeah.
good.
All right. Yeah. So now this is your first time, both
yes.
of you. You live in New York.
Yes.
So your first time here. What is it like to people watching at home?
Well, to the people watching at home, you know, it's a completely different vibe because you're warm at home, you feel the things. But when you're here, you just feel the atmosphere of all the different people from all the different places, and it's really a great place to be.
And what's your most excited, what are you most excited about for tonight?
Definitely seeing the ball drop and welcoming in the new year, for sure.
I love it. All right, so for everyone back home watching, let's give a big Happy New Year on three. One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
I'm feeling a lot of recurring themes here tonight in regards to parents bringing their children to New Year's Eve in Times Square. What's your name, hon?
Marianela.
And your name?
Stephanie.
And so mom brought Stephanie to Times Square for New Year's Eve. What made you want to be here this year?
Well, everything here is great. I love it. I think I want to live here.
And what's the most exciting thing you've done in New York City since you've been here?
Well, I just got here today, so this has been the most exciting thing I've done.
What are you looking forward to tonight the most?
The new year.
The new year. Do you have any New Year's resolutions you want to share?
Work out? I guess, yeah.
You're like 20 pounds wet. What do you need to work out for?
I need to get bigger.
And what about you, Mom? Any New Year's resolutions?
I need to work out, too.
Oh, it seems another recurring theme, working out. I'm going to work out, too. How about that?
Okay,
how about
right
on the count of three, we're all going to yell a great big Happy New Year's to the camera. One, two, three. Happy New Year!
So surreal to me. It still hasn't hit me.
I've been going to games since I was in my mom's tummy. This means everything to me.
I am done competing, but by no means does this mean that it's the end of my career. It's the start of something new.
I just wish that we could find a way to have a positive dialogue.
Really, all we want is to be policed the same way everybody else is policed.
We're hurting. Our profession is hurting. Dallas officers are hurting.
This is not just a bathroom bill, but it's a bill to our civil rights.
We're out here because a pipeline is threatening the rights of indigenous people.
These are purely people who have been uprooted and had to leave their homes and communities because of recent conflicts.
The biggest thing they have is they're afraid. They've been 2 years under ISIS.
I'm absolutely confident that ISIL will lose. We will prevail.
We gotta learn to actually love each other. There's too much hate in this world. It's not fair to come together under tragic circumstances.
We go around looking like an idiot, holding in the phone, catching all these Pikachus and Charizards.
We're going to free up people to do things that are higher value. There's going to be amazing new ways of working that don't exist yet.
When I'm talking about Zika to you today, I'm not talking about something that's happening halfway around the world. I'm talking about something that's happening where we live.
Success of it.
Voters here in Iowa are set to begin the process of selecting the next president.
We will make America great again.
First time in our nation's history that a woman will be a major party's nominee.
In a stunning victory that shocked the nation, billionaire businessman Donald Trump won the U.S. presidential election.
To all the little girls are watching this, never doubt that you are valuable and powerful.
Now it's time for America to bind the wounds of division.
We're not Democrats first, we're not Republicans first, we are Americans first.
You can spend time going back and forth, but it doesn't change anything. The results are still the same. But you can make a difference yourself by how you treat people and how you deal with people.
Have you seen
never go touch ya, but I see you touch ya.
Happy 2017. This is time for Happy New Year's, everybody. How you doing?
Happy New Year's.
Good.
Good. All right, good. Now, what's your names? Where are you from?
Giovanna from Ecuador.
Ecuador. What's up, Ecuador? What's your names?
Luciana from Argentina.
Argentina, Ecuador. What's your name? Where are you from?
Naum, and I'm from Hoboken.
Hoboken. What's up? Your name?
Maximo Rivera.
All right. And what's your name? Where are you from?
Luciana. I'm from Hackensack.
All right. We got Hackensack, Ecuador. This is the entire world in one place. Now, what's been the best part of today?
That it's going to be a new year, and that this is my first time seeing the ball drop.
All right. Now, it's his first time. It's going to be fun. Now, everyone, I want you to look into this camera and say Happy New Year, okay? One, two, three.
Kim.
And I understand you two are good friends. And how did you meet?
At work.
And then I know you were really excited to come to New York. And how did that come about?
We started as a joke. I said, guys, let's go to New York for the first time. It's always a lot of fun over there. And they went for it. And here we are.
We're here.
So the joke then became reality.
Yeah.
And so what is it like finally being here?
Oh, it's
amazing!
Yes, came true. Yes, yes. We still cannot believe, but you know, we are very happy, happy, happy to be here.
And of course, you have these amazing glasses. Where did you get these glasses from?
Party City!
Party City! Woo! All right. So, what is your wish for 2017?
To be healthy.
Keep my family growing.
I love it. All right, well, let's get a big Happy New Year on three to everyone back home.
Ready?
You guys ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
Put your empty hands in mine. And scars, show me all the scars you hide. And hey, if your wings are broken, please take mine so yours can open too. 'Cause I'm gonna stand by you. No tears make a lot of scopes in your eyes. And hurt, I know you're hurting, but so am I. And love, if your wings are broken, borrow mine so yours can open too. 'Cause I'm gonna stand by you. Even if we're breaking down, we can find a way to break through. Even if we can't find.
I'm gonna stand by you.
Even if we can't find
City. This is about not giving up on yourself, no matter what. Sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say, wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream on the loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Friends and I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried about me. In too deep, say I'm in too deep. And it's been 2 years, I miss my home. But there's a fire burning in my bones. I still believe, yeah, I still believe. And all of those things I didn't say, wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream out loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I am alright song. My power's turned up. Started right now, I'll be strong. And I'll play my fight song. And I don't really care what nobody else believes. Come on, cause I've still got a lot of fight left. Sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. Might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. Still got a lot of fire left in me. I love you guys. Happy New Year. Thank you so much.
Any New Year's resolutions?
Collectively committed.
More love.
More love.
Break a leg, guys. More love. Joe Jonas. More love.
I'm here with platinum selling producer, rapper, and songwriter, Silento. Is there anything you don't do?
Well, I don't be negative.
Oh,
well,
there you go. That's even better. What do you think of all this? I mean, you're here in the middle of Times Square on New Year's Eve. How do you feel?
I feel awesome. I feel it's so much amazing energy out here. I just want to turn up tonight.
Right? You can feel it. You can feel it. Now, what goes through your head when you're performing in the middle of Times Square on New Year's Eve? I mean, that's insane.
Well, it's just like, oh my God, it's like a dream that I had in high school, and it's finally here, so watch me.
Dreams come true, people. See, dreams do come true. Now, I opened the show with me trying to whip a nene. I am horrible at it, and I have absolutely no rhythm, so I want to learn from the best. Can you just give me, like, the rundown, like, 4 or 5 basic moves from the pro himself? We got the man, the legend. All right, how do we do it?
So you take your arm and you
work. Got it.
Then you can
nay-nay. Nay-nay. And then all the way back until I fall off the stage. Okay, good. No. Okay, so one more time. One more time. Whip. And then I whip, and then I whip. Nay, nay, nay. Okay, I'm going to have to practice this. I got voted off Dancing with the Stars very quickly. Oh, well, I don't know. How do I do that? Break your legs. Oh, I can do this. Oh, now I can't get up. I'm too old. You got to help me up. Too old for this. All right, there we go. All right, now watch me got 2.5 million YouTube hits in the first week. I mean, what was that like watching 2.5 million in the first? Did you just sit and just count them? Because I would just sit and I just count them, go yes, up the whole time, refresh.
I sat and counted them as well as counting them. I still was posting all my fans online dancing to my songs. Worldwide.
Your fans absolutely love you. Like, what's one of the best fan interactions you've had last year?
When I went to Brazil. Sao Paulo and Rio, it was amazing.
And Brazil, I mean, it's beautiful there too. Yeah. So, now, what's coming up for you in 2017?
2017, my EP will be coming out. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel, Salento TV, Salento Vivo. I have a new emoji shoe. You can purchase it on velatofootwear.com. We only have 1,700 pair left. So, with that being said, you can, as well as that, you can go check out my merchandise. I got new merch, new album, just a new me, new management. If you couldn't book me last year, you have nobody to contact, salentoblessings@gmail.com. Let's go.
I mean, you're your own PR person. Just fire everyone. You got it. You're like Madonna, a one-man show.
Actually, when I was in high school, I had a hit. I decided to stay in public school, so that hindered my success. So I had to figure out what I was going to do because I had a manager, but my manager was my producer. You can't be a manager and be my producer. So I had to go ahead and find me a team and start over new when I got out of high school because it was only me and my career was about to fall, but I'm picking it up. 2017 is mine.
Well, it definitely is yours. Everybody loves you. I love you. I think you're so cool. He has such a great energy, guys. He's so amazing to be around. I think we should say happy whipping nay nay year to everyone, right? All right, on the count of three, happy whipping nay nay year 2017. Wow!
And Prince Salento, baby.
Oh, hi. Didn't know you were there. I was dancing with my girl over here. So tell them your name and where you're from.
My name is Joan, and I'm from Middletown, Connecticut. And I've been coming to Times Square for 18 years now to celebrate my birthday tomorrow morning.
Oh, my gosh.
12:01. And it's pretty nice. It's not that cold.
It is. No, she's absolutely right. It is beautiful out here. And also, you get good energy like this. It's beautiful as well. Now, I love the hat. Hold up, you've been coming here every year for a while. What's been some highlights of coming to Times Square?
Well, sometimes it's real cold. I mean, freezing. And then one time it was 75 degrees. We were sitting in front of McDonald's eating sundaes.
That's what I'm talking about.
When I brought my daughter.
That's awesome. And that's what can happen when you come to Times Square for New Year's. And now 2017, few hours. What do you want for next year? What's going on?
I want to lose 20 pounds.
20 pounds.
Or more.
There's a way I can help you do that. It's called dancing. It's called dancing. It's dancing. We're going to dance. You enjoy your New Year's. We'll see you soon. Bye.
Prison guard's sign. I don't need to be anything other than a specialist sign. I don't have to be anyone other than both the two souls in one. Part of where I'm going is knowing where I'm coming from. And I don't want to be anything other than what I've been trying to be lately. All I have to do is sink in me. That peace of mind. I'm tired of looking around, wondering what I gotta do or who I'm supposed to be. I don't wanna be anything other than me. Yeah. Hey.
surrounded by liars. Everywhere I turn, surrounded by imposters. Everywhere I turn, surrounded by identity crisis. Everywhere I turn, am I the only one who noticed? I can't be the only one who's learned. I don't wanna be anything other than what I've been trying to be lately. All I have to do is sing me that peace of mind. I'm tired of looking around, wondering what I got to do, who I'm supposed to be. Everyone's attention, please. If you're not locked this in bed, you're gonna have to leave. I came from the mountain, the crust of creation. My whole situation made from clay to stone. Now I'm telling everybody, I don't wanna be anything other than what I've been trying to be lately. All I have to do is sink me out of peace of mind. I'm tired of looking around, who's wondering what I gotta do, or who I'm supposed to be. I don't wanna be anything other than me.
on there? Is it a thing I wouldn't do? I could get back on the right track, but only if you'd be convinced. So until then, if you ask me how I'm doing, I would say I'm doing just fine.
I'm the only person sitting down in Times Square right now, but I'm not going to apologize for that. What is your name?
My name is Laura Rivera.
And your name, sir?
Jazz Montesinos.
Now, tell me where you are from again.
I'm from Bolivia.
Bolivia! I had to ask where that was. I had no idea. Have you ever met anyone from Bolivia? I haven't. This is a first for me. So what made you want to be in Times Square for New Year's Eve?
It was on my bucket list. It's once in a lifetime. I see this like every year on my TV, so why not be here in person?
Now, what were you doing last year for New Year's Eve? Anything exciting?
No, it was just some party, just the same usual with family.
Some party with family. I'm not going to ask any questions. So you got somebody to kiss at midnight. You think we could get a little preview of what we're going to see at midnight?
Sure.
Okay.
All right. That's what it's all about. On the count of three, Happy New Year's to everybody back home. One, two, three. Happy New Year's!
So much energy! I love you guys! What are your names?
Glorenis, Liliani,
Dennis.
And where are you from?
Puerto Rico!
Oh, you brought a flag! Amazing! So this is like your family, your whole family is here. Liking New York?
I love New York. I love the Empire State and Times Square. I love it.
And what's your favorite part about this whole experience?
See the ball, get down, and have fun.
And you guys have a really good prime spot for the ball drop, which is really cool. All right, so 2017 is right around the corner. What is your wish? What do you want for this new year?
A lot of healthy and to be the best year of my life.
Yeah.
Just to spend time with my family, friends, and also have healthy, love, money,
love.
Finish my college, and a great year.
I love it. All right, so for everyone back in Puerto Rico, let's give a big Happy New Year on three. Okay. Really, really loud. Okay. You ready?
Okay.
One, two, three.
Everyone, hope you're enjoying the countdown. We are almost there, but not quite. First, let's find out some people. What's your name? Where are you from?
My name is Jim. I'm from Chicago, Illinois.
Chicago, what's your day been like today? What time did you get here? What happened?
Oh, it's been insane. We got in yesterday. We went through chaos to get here. Literally, like, shuffling through like this. I thought I was going to die. I didn't even know I was going to make it here. But we're here. We're having a great time. Everyone, is it awesome? You guys are awesome.
This is the crowd. This right here is the crowd. Wow. See what's going on here. We're from all over the world. We are live. And we are live. We are live. We are live. We are live. Hold up. Where are you from?
Mexico!
Are you from Mexico? You need to go to Mexico. Hang out with them.
Mexico! Woo! Mexico! I can go to
Mexico! Let's say Happy New Year. One, two, three.
Happy New Year!
Tell the world I'll sing a song. It's a better place since you came along. Since you came along. Your touch is sunlight through the trees. Your kisses are the ocean breeze. Everything's alright when you're with me. And oh, you're my favorite thing. Oh, the love that you bring. But it feels like I've opened my eyes again. And the colors are golden and bright again. There's a sun in my heart. I feel like I belong. It's a better place since you came along. Better place since you came along. I see the whole world in your eyes. It's like I've known you all my life. It just feels so right. So I pour my heart into your hands. It's like you really understand. You love the way I am.
Tradition. I think more than ever right now, we need to hear these words. We need to sing this song together. So if you know the words, please join me. This is how we change the world.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. Above us, only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Ooh. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for, and no religions too.
Dreamer. New York. town blues. Are melting away. I'm gonna make a brand new start of it in old New York. And if I can make it there, I'm gonna make it anywhere. It's up to you.
Actually had the best time of my entire life. I can't explain what it's like to be here right now. I mean, how was your guys' night? Tell me everything.
It was incredible. The energy, people here, a lot of love. I found a lot of love in the air, people. It was fun. It was a good time.
It was a really good year. I mean, every year is great, but this one year was especially great. And then the countdown, for me, is always, I could cry. I could cry every time.
I know. I had tears in my eyes.
So it was really cool. And I got a selfie with Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Mike, how was your night?
I agree with Jeremy. There was a lot of love in the air, but one thing I noticed I heard over and over again, bucket list. This is my bucket list. I've always wanted to be here. I heard I've been waiting 30 years, 40 years to be here, and finally we've made it to Times Square. I talked to a family who had been saving all year. He had like 5 kids to bring everybody here and spend New Year's Eve with us. I think that's super special.
All right, you guys, you know what? Let's all do a toast to 2017. Thanks to Barefoot Bubbly, our friends over there. Here's to good ships and wood ships and ships that sail the sea. But the best ships are friendships, so may they always be.
Wow. Oh, that's really good.
That was elegant,
Jonathan.
Yeah. Jonathan.
That's college there. That's what that is. All right, so what are your wishes for 2017?
2017, what I want for all of us is to be more patient with each other. We're all in a rush. We want to go places. But take a minute, smile, and let's enjoy the ride.
Well said. I would say positive
vibes. I don't know, we're starting a new year. Why not be positive and treat everyone really, really well?
I've got a couple. I want to spend as much time with my beautiful wife and my three-year-old son, August. Papa loves you. I'm coming home soon. Yeah. And I want next year, mark my words, I'm going to get on this table. I'm going to have abs next year.
Yes.
I want Jonathan Bennett abs. I want Aaron Samuels abs.
You're going to have Aaron Samuels
and I will
mean
show
girls abs.
On this show next
the world.
Year.
Absolutely.
The world heard you, Mike. Are you sure?
You have to do it now.
Now I have to do it. Or I have to quit and not come back.
My resolution is, and my wish for 2017 is to go on more adventures. I have people in my life that I want to go on adventures with, and I think it's time to go on more adventures in 2017. That's definitely it. Well, you know, what's the craziest thing you guys saw out there tonight? What's the craziest thing?
The craziest thing I saw was I became a love doctor. I set some people up and made love happen.
Wow.
That was how crazy.
All right, we have our very own Cupid in the house, guys.
There is this lady from Houston that was so excited to be here that she wasn't even listening to the questions I was asking her. Because all she could do was cheer and go, yeah! And I feel like she probably doesn't have a voice anymore. But her excitement was just so thrilling and amazing.
Andrea, I don't listen when you talk either. It's fine.
No,
I'm just kidding.
That was really personal. Okay, whatever.
Mike, what'd you see?
I saw a lot of things, but the opportunity to speak with some awesome people, Joe Jonas, Gloria Estefan, Gavin DeGraw, there were some awesome people here this year, a lot of fun, and I think Mariah Carey was a big surprise.
Yeah, let's talk about the Mariah Carey upset of 2017. Like, what was that? That was, I've never seen anything like that happen.
All she has to do is show up, it's Mariah Carey.
Always a win.
Yeah, I mean, Maravieu, we love you very much. What'd you think about the performance? Says overall, though, everyone else. Did you meet anyone good?
Oh, I thought Gavin DeGraw was awesome. I thought Gavin had the whole crowd. Good times.
Interviewed Rachel Platten, and she was very, very amazing. And her song, just in general, Fight Song, I think is super inspiring, especially going into a new year.
Yeah.
You know?
That song has so much meaning to it. Yes.
You know, I've been spending some time with Prince Salento over the last couple of days. He's been coaching me on the whip Nay Nay, and I never even had an opportunity to show anybody how actually really good I got at the whip Nay Nay.
Well,
but maybe next year I'll bring that back with my abs.
Yes, you will. All right, guys. Well, it's about time to say goodnight. Thank you to everyone who joined us in Times Square and online tonight. A special thanks to our crew and our correspondents, the awesome Jeremy, Andrea, and Mike, and to our host, Allison. And thank you all for watching us and having us be a part of your night. I'm Jonathan Bennett, and we will see you next year.
Happy New Year! What a wonderful world.
Square 2017 was presented by Planet Fitness. We'd also like to thank our partners Barefoot Bubbly, Kiss Bang Love, Philips Lighting, Shred It, the Sino-American Friendship Association, Toshiba, and Waterford. On behalf of the Times Square Alliance and Countdown Entertainment, we would like to thank the Mayor's Office, the New York City Police, Fire, Sanitation, and Transportation Departments, and most of all, we want to thank you guys for coming out tonight to celebrate with us. Have a safe trip home, and don't forget to log on to TimesSquareNYC.org or TimesSquareBall.net and see yourselves ringing in the new year. I'm Allison Hagendorf. Follow me at Allie Hagendorf, and thank you so much for joining us. Happy New Year, and good night, Times Square.
Let's go.
Texas.
inside my brain. You're somewhere in my DNA. You got me way up in the sky, sky, sky. Just pull me closer in the night, night, night. But I'm only human. Just what can I do? 'Cause I feel the fusion when I'm there with you.
I've been watching you, you've been hurting too. You give all your love, nothing left to show. I have been there too, alone.